To begin, you will need a footage of the paper unfold animation, and I'm going to provide this particular example that I'm using in the video description. So we begin by adding it to the timeline. Then if we scroll a bit forward, we can see that this example has an additional background behind the green screen, and we need to remove that first. If yours doesn't have it, you can just skip this step. If we open effects and presets and search for key light, then add it to the paper unfold, then in effect controls we select the eyedropper next to screen color and click on the background color to remove it. Then we go back to the project window and add the logo or whatever it is that we want to add the effect to onto the timeline above the paper unfold. Then we press S on the keyboard to reduce the scale of the logo. Then it's best if we scroll forward until the green screen of the paper unfold is fully visible, and then we adjust the size and position of the logo to make sure it's inside of the green screen. Then we right click on the logo, select pre-compose, call this logo, make sure you check move attributes, then click OK. And we do this to make sure we can easily replace the logo for something else if we need to. Then we select the logo, go up to Edit, Duplicate, or we press Ctrl D as the shortcut. Then we need the track mat settings. If you don't see them, click Toggle Switches on Modes, and then set the track mat of the paper unfold to the logo layer above it. Then we select these two layers at the bottom, the paper unfold and the logo, right click, pre-compose, you can call this paper, click OK. Then we need to duplicate this paper, so select it, Ctrl D, then drag the logo that's at the top to the bottom and set its track mat to the paper layer above it. And now the only thing that's left is to key out the green of the layer at the top. So again, we add the key light to the top layer. Then in effect controls, we select the eyedropper and click on the green color. And that way our paper unfold animation is done. So here we have it. And to replace the logo, it's super easy. We just jump into the logo comp and here we use a different logo. So let me drag it over here. So make sure you adjust the size and position of the new logo to match the previous logo's size, then hide the previous logo, then we go back to the main composition, and now we have the same animation, just for a different logo.